Hello and welcome to our tutorial, and we are going to build on our character here. Just going to slide this across. Going to try and make something not quite the same as this, but in this style, so like an old flight kind of helmet. And why are we going to do that? Well, it saves me having to model a whole bunch of head. So I'm going to add a cube and scale that cube down, and I'll move that up there. Now I'm using a cube because I want quads, so I'm going to add a subsurface modifier and increase the views to 2, and then I'm going to hit apply. And then I'm going to do that again, add another subsurface modifier and set it to smooth. I'm going to go into edit mode and delete half of it, and then immediately add a mirror modifier. Okay, so we are kind of ready to go. And so the bit that we want to get, so we're going to remove these verts here and these verts here. So that's sort of the shape of the helmet that we're going to make. Now it's not totally round, so we're going to scale it on X. Before we do that, we're going to turn on clipping. So scale on X and then G on X to about there. And move that in a bit. Okay, so that's what we've got. Now we're going to create sort of what we call it, a rim to this. It's not a hat, but we'll call it a hat. So we'll select these faces here and this is all quite kind of crude, but so we're going to go E and then escape and then scale. Again, just to kind of give it a shape. And so the major feature of these things is the sort of the earpiece, so kind of a cylindrical or sorry, circular sort of earpiece. So I'll select here and go Shift S, cursor to selected, and then we're going to add a circle. We definitely don't want 32, we'll put in 12 verts. We're going to turn off clipping because this is going to be bigger than the circle, so or bigger than the side. Rotate it 90 and look from the side again. So now we'll position that about there. So now we'll go into vertex select, so we'll select those three and delete them. Okay, and then we're going to try and fill in the gaps. So some of these are strikingly straightforward. So, and then some of them will have to be a bit more creative with and add in a loop cut maybe. So we'll do the obvious ones first, and the more difficult ones second. So again, all the time we're trying to keep quads. Now if we don't get quads, it's not the end of the world, because a lot of this won't deform, so it's mission critical to keep them as quads in the areas that are gonna physically change a lot. But yeah. So we're gonna extrude escape and just bring it in fractionally, maybe move it in that way. And E and scale it in, and then E and X. And oops. So it's always a good idea to have a look on the non sort of on the mirrored side. It gives you a better idea of how it looks, and we'll just increase the subdivision to 2. That's not too bad. Now we've lots and lots of detail to add in, and yeah, a lot to do with it, but not a bad start. So I'm going to add a loop cut here. Get rid of that. Oops. Piece there, and then add a loop cut here. Now, what we want to do is select these guys and extrude and scale . Now I'm going to go in and manually move these a bit. So in these sort of helmets, there's normally sort of an extra piece of kind of cloth here that has kind of latches or catches, whatever you want to call them, on them. So we'll do that, and then these ones are more. So I'm going to go cursor to selected and add a circle. And this one's going to have maybe 8, so it'll be a simpler and place that there and select this face, X faces, activert select. So probably looking at putting a loop cut through there, and that one through there. Probably need one into there. One, 2, 3, 4. That is correct. Even if we do two of them, that'll be enough for what we're trying to do. So what we'll do is use C for our select tool. We'll go Shift D and move that to there. Oops. We'll go to face select and rid ourselves of these two, and then try and join up the outside of this. And hopefully this won't. Okay, so let's. So I'm just going to scale this up a bit so that I know I'm using the right or the correct verts, and then I can always scale it back in. Again, I need a loop cut here. Oops, so another one. So face. So, and what we'll very simply do is we will give so let's just bring this over here, and we will go this is not green, definitely, but it's probably the closest that we've got, so I'm going to save that. I'll put that to my desktop. With the other images that we're using. So I'm going to unwrap this. Let's go U unwrap, and I'm not unhappy with that at all. I'm going to go open, and onto the desktop there's brown leather, so we can open this one, and we will give this a material, and then in the node editor we will simply use this here. So let's get rid of this guy, add in a principal shader, put that in there, add in our image texture, link that in there, and then bring in that one and see what it looks like rendered. And we'll bring back its specularity and its roughness. And what we'll do is we will That's a bit warm for a sun, so I'll bring it down to, oh, a bit too dark. There we go. So that's not too bad. And we can always scale it up. Now the only other thing I want to do is create a new layer on this, and we're going to select the button material. We can always change this later. I'm going to go into edit mode and select, make sure we have all that selected. And we also want to select this here, not the outer one, and same here. But not the outer one. Okay, and then we're going to assign the button material to them. Okay. So again, far from perfect, but totally right for what we're doing. So okay, so let's rename this hat, and let's take our lamp that is at the spot. Okay, far too much. So that's also a sun. We don't want you to be a sun. Well, we do, but we just want you to be over there with a strength of 1. And so, yeah, it's not too bad. I'm going to very quickly just adjust the UV map. So actually I'm going to deselect this. I'm just going to take the brown leather and select that, so not the others. And I'm going to scale it up by 2. And we've got this sort of these lines, and normally if you got them on a texture that would be like an error, but in this instance here it is just right, and it means the texture is a bit more to scale, a bit more proportionate to how it should be. So I'm happier with that look, although it does look a little bit like a riding helmet, but we'll live with that. Okay, so we are going to leave it at that for now, and when we come back in our next tutorial we will make the face that goes inside that.